Lincoln's Sitting Room, April 8, 1973, President Nixon and John Ehrlichman. Segment 1.
Mitchell, of course, is going to be put to the prod on this one. That's right. Mitchell has got to decide whether he's going to tell John Dean, look here, I don't think you ought to say a word or you got to go down the line. Well, John is not going to lie.
He says John Mitchell is sort of living in a dream world right now. He thinks this is all going to go away.
He thinks that?
Yeah.
John Dean thinks that Mitchell's living in a dream world?
Yeah. He thinks that that's Mitchell's frame of mind on all of this. First, he hasn't bothered to retain counsel. He hasn't really done much about preparing himself or anything of this kind. So,
what does Dean think about it?
Well, Dean says it isn't going to go away. It's right on top of us, and that the smartest thing that he, Dean, can do is go down there and appear cooperative.
Segment 2.
We felt out of not only fairness, but also in order to make sure that nobody thought that the White House was bombing him, that John ought to talk to these fellows and let them know what it is he's intending to do.
When does he have to decide this?
Well, he has to get in touch with them tonight, and he thought that he probably would see them tomorrow night.
Right.
See, they prepare their case at night and work the jury during the day.
So he'll tell them that tomorrow night I'll talk to you, and tonight he says, what's he going to say tonight?
Well, he just says, give me an appointment tomorrow night.
Oh, he'll go over and see him.
Yeah.
Right. I think he has to do that. That's right.
All right, sir.
Well, but he's got to lay it off pretty hard with Mitchell that he hasn't got any choice on this, that he will not